keep up with Power 108.9 on social media.
How can I find you?
Instagram.
At Power 108.9.
And Facebook.
At Power 108.9.
It's the exact same thing. It's at Power 108.9.
Oh, okay.
Power 108.9. A station for the people.
Hi, Queens. Hi, Queens. Welcome to the Ollie Tony Experience in Atlanta, your source for all things fashion and hair.
Yeah. Baby, I'm just trying to let my hair down.
Please visit us online at shopollietony.com and follow us on Instagram at Ollie Tony Star.
The opinions and views expressed by this program are those of the program, program host, and guest, and do not necessarily reflect the views of Power 108.9 and its officials. We hope you enjoy.
From Christal with love, come on. From Christal with love, come on. Let's talk.
Look here, I ain't the type that be writing
all
love.
All right, happy Tuesday. Happy Tuesday to everyone out there. And welcome to another edition of From Christal with Love XO. I, of course, am your host, Christal Jordan. I'm so excited to have you all here. It is absolutely beautiful Tuesday here in Atlanta, Georgia. I hope that you had a great weekend. A lot happened this weekend. We had the Dogwood Festival here in Atlanta. I am a person that loves to enjoy outdoor events. I've realized that about myself the older I've gotten, that I've actually really enjoy outdoor events. So the Dogwood Festival is something I didn't get a chance to go, but I actually hated that. I was working. We were in the middle of some extreme spring cleaning, trying to get the new house together, trying to get out of my old house completely, which is not easy, especially when you are merging households, right? I'm learning. I got married in October. We are in the process of trying to take my house, my old house, and merge it with our new house. And the process has become a little overwhelming. So I'm in the middle of that. So I didn't get a chance to enjoy the Dogwood Festival. And I didn't really watch a lot of television either. I actually kind of took a break from social media, just doing a lot of spring cleaning stuff. There are some headlines that we cannot escape. We know everyone is still, of course, talking about the Oscars. I had the opportunity to interview T.S. Madison. You guys can check that out on my YouTube channel. Interviewed T.S. Madison yesterday, and we talked about several things. First of all, T.S. Madison is in the middle of the Monique Lee Daniels reunion. I don't know if you guys remember, but T.S. Madison, she was a part of the Queen's Court with Kaya. They actually kind of really kicked off talk shows on social media platforms, right? So they're the Queen's Court on YouTube was huge. Had a huge following, and I think led to them getting an opportunity to work with another network. But Monique's interview with the two of them actually caused them to split up. And so T.S. was given another opportunity with Fox Soul by herself. Monique was the finale of her last season, and she talked very candidly about the issue and the fact that she felt like she had been blacklisted from Black Hollywood, especially via Lee Daniels and Tyler Perry, Oprah Winfrey. A lot of people, she just didn't agree with the way they handled the situation. I know you guys know about the whole thing with the movie Precious and how Monique decided that she was no longer going to promote for free. She was going to focus on family first. They had a big fallout. Unfortunately, at the time, Monique was at the height of her career. The movie Precious ended up getting nominated. I think she won a Golden Globe for that. But they have had this rift since then. Oprah and Tyler tried to help the situation, ended up actually making it worse. But after all these years, Monique goes on T.S. Madison's talk with her and shares her heart. T.S. is good friends with Lee Daniels. The next thing we know, the two of them, Lee Daniels at an event mentions that he, you know, goes up there. He and Monique have this really heartfelt moment where he's like, I want to work with you again. It's all love. It was beautiful. I think we need to see more things like that. And so T.S. had Lee Daniels as the first guest on her new season. So she ended the season with Monique, started her new season on Fox Soul with Lee Daniels. And definitely check out that interview. I had a chance to watch that before I talked to T.S. Madison. But she had some interesting things to say. She definitely, I asked her what she thought would have happened differently with the Will Smith and Chris Rock situation if Chris Rock had been gay, right? Because I'm starting to believe that there is this, we are protecting the LGBTQ community. We are also protecting Black women. But it does seem like Black men, no one really cares. I mean, they are kind of left out to dry. And so I asked her what her opinion was, and she was very clear that if Chris Rock had been gay, that the entire energy towards the event would have been totally different. I feel like when people watched Chris Rock get slapped, nobody really cared. Like, nobody felt empathy for him the way they would have if he had been obviously a woman or gay or any other number of things that we just don't look out for men, you know, with. So anyway, let me know what you guys think about that. TS was very clear. She was like, you know, that if he was gay, immediately he would have gotten jumped. Immediately the LGBTQ community would have jumped him. And which is cool. I don't have a problem with that. My only issue is the fact that we cannot protect one community without looking out for all of us, right? And so I think that we need to think about that. And especially as we talk about canceling people, and it shouldn't only be cool to cancel if you are in one community. That's not cool, you know? So anyway, that's just my opinion, but I enjoyed the interview with T.S. Madison. I have something else coming up with her that I cannot wait to share with you guys. But today I have a very, very beautiful in-studio guest who's going to hang out with us. She is one of the actresses on Bounce TV's highest rated series, Saints and Sinners. So you guys stay right there. We're going to come right back with the very beautiful Jasmine Burke. All right, stay right there. This is From Christal XL. I'm your host, Christal, and I will be right here when you guys get back. Let's spend lunch together.
Keep it locked. Power 108.9, the station for the people. Keep up with Power 108.9 on social media.
How can I find you?
Instagram
at Power 108.9
and Facebook
at Power 108.9.
It's the exact same thing. It's at Power 108.9.
Oh, okay.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
My powerful and pristine people, it's your boy E-Money, your favorite engineer. Check it out. If you want to get involved with Power 108.9 as far as partnerships and advertising, if you want to reach our 50,000 plus listeners and viewers per week, please email power1089ads@gmail.com. That's power1089ads@gmail.com. Speak to our marketing director so we can get you set up and ready to go. Let us help you reach your targeted audience and expand your brand.
Question: what's the only station where you can get R&B, hip-hop, pop, and talk radio? Time's up.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
I really like the after effect of when, you know, the Denzel, Tyler Perry moment. I think that was not highlighted enough. I think if I wild out, y'all would be the ones on the side like Elam.
I'd be like cool.
This. After that.
Elam slapped the shit out of him.
And then there's them.
He going to jail.
Get yourself some mentors. Get yourself the right mentors. If you have the wrong people in your camp, this is the stuff that can happen.
Sue the light bulb off his t-shirt. I don't give a damn.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
Hey Atlanta, this is Sayon, and you're listening to Power 108.9.
All right, we are back. We are back with the very beautiful Jasmine Burke in studio. Hey, lady.
Hello.
It's so good to actually have people here. You are one of my favorite actresses here because we've had a chance to watch your career grow so much over the last, I would say, maybe like 5 to 10 years. Like, you've been at this for a while. And so every time I see you doing something, I'm like, oh my God. Not the fact that you handle it so well and you are so humble and gracious, but you're also so dope at what you do. And more opportunities continue to come your way.
Yes. Thank you.
Of course. So before we get into the Saints and Sinners, I have a gift. I have a gift for you. So
I love gifts.
Oh, well, you know, women love gifts. And, yes.
It's one of my love languages.
It is my primary love language.
Is your number one?
It is my primary, yes.
Yeah, it makes you feel special.
It does. But see, because it's my primary love language, that's how I show other people I appreciate them. So I am big on, okay, what can I do? You know, so thankfully my sponsors get that. Yes. And I also have mostly women, which is great because, you know, I get a chance to do something to show them how much we appreciate what they do. So anyway, this is not big, but just something small to you from Christal XO and the good people at Ollie Tony.
Oh, wonderful.
So before I do this, I always look through social media, right?
Yes.
So I look through, and you had this. First of all, Jasmine's body is like goals, right? I don't know if that's youth mixed up with a lot of working out and not eating certain things or whatever, or just jeans. But whatever it is, you look amazing. There's a picture of you in a pink swimsuit.
Oh.
Yeah.
With the bucket hat.
Yeah. So that hat actually matches the swimsuit.
Ooh, this is
super cute, right?
Oh, yeah.
So just, I mean, for the beach, but really only with that swimsuit, because that swimsuit was, you were making quite a statement. And I want you to continue to make a statement. Yes. So that's a little extra. And then we just wanted to give you a little bit of your own swag from Ollie Tony. So this is your own. Your t-shirt with your hashtag and your handle on that. So people remember to follow at the Jasmine Burke, right?
Yeah,
and it has to be in pink.
Has to be
in pink, sparkly.
Totally right.
Yeah, just it has to be enchanted. So just a little something. Cute. So we got you a sweatshirt and a t-shirt just for hanging out. But you got to wear that bucket hat with that swimsuit, because that swimsuit, like I said, you made quite a statement.
Let me explain something about that vacation. And thank you so much. I'm definitely
more than
going
welcome.
To support these. I love gifts, and these are wonderful.
You are more than
thank
welcome.
You.
We're so happy to have you here in studio.
Just put them right here?
Yeah, you can just put them right down. Here? Yep.
Okay. So a little bit about that vacation. I have been working so hard. Mm-hmm. You know, we had just finished filming the sixth season of Saints and Sinners.
Right.
And I just thought, I have been thinking to myself throughout the few years, mm-hmm. I have to enjoy this more.
Right.
Like I worked so hard, and mm-hmm. I'm always thinking about the next success, the next accomplishment,
the next
achievement. Like mm-hmm. I am a success.
You're driven.
I'm obsessed with success.
Right. Okay.
For many reasons, you know. Mm-hmm. One, I never want to be poor again. Like, growing up poor sucked.
Right.
Financially poor.
Right. Right.
Spiritually very rich, but you know, drove me. And seeing my mother work so hard and break her back to take care of us, mm-hmm. I was like, you know what? I really want to follow my dream and make the life that I want for myself. So that drives me, right? Mm-hmm. And once you get a taste of being able to make your dream come true and support yourself from it,
reach.
You realize, oh, this is possible.
Yes.
This is not a dream. This is real.
I can do this.
But then you realize, you have to keep working hard for it every single day.
And then you're not really ever satisfied, because you know that there's another level that you can get to.
It's levels. But that vacation, right? So mm-hmm. I was like, okay, I'm going to, this year I'm enjoying this mm-hmm. every step of the way. So mm-hmm. I said, I'm taking myself on a vacation.
Nice.
And so I took myself to, and I love tropical islands. So mm-hmm. I took myself to a tropical island, and I went shopping for myself.
Yes.
I bought bikinis, and I was I'm about to have photo shoots on the beach.
Yes.
Like, I'm doing this. And I just did it. And so that pink bikini and that bucket hat, that is me celebrating myself.
I love that. That's even better, because you look like that.
Yeah.
But now we know the message was consistent with the look. Right?
Yes.
You know, it's interesting, because I hear you say that, and I can relate a lot to that. I grew up in a single parent family, and my mother just struggled really hard, right? And I think there's something to not feeling like you don't have control. Because I think for me, I was the kid that hated being a kid.
Mm.
I did not like being I always wanted to be an adult. Okay. I always wanted to be able to fix the situation, right? I mm-hmm. always, whenever we would be going through some type of challenge, I always thought, well, I knew I could contribute. I just mm-hmm. couldn't, because I was young, you know? So that feeling of not having control was one I did not like.
Yeah.
And so I think a lot of times when you hear women especially have that experience of growing up a certain way, it's like, I don't want to ever be not in control of my destiny. I feel like when I was younger, you know, being in a family where we didn't have certain things, I had no say so and was not able to contribute. So you just have to kind of make it make sense. And so then it creates this desire, an internal motivation, right? But then when you get there, you realize, oh, wait a minute, I got to balance this out. Yes. Because work does not feed you.
No.
Right? No. So how, and I want to get into this because you guys, this is the final season of Saints and Sinners on Bounce. And I want to talk about how it's like the little show that could.
Yes.
Because it has, you know, you guys have broken records and done all this stuff. But before we get into that, just more about yourself and seeing that, like, when, at what point did you realize, okay, this is like, because you've starred in, you've been had leading roles in films and different things like that. What is something that happened that you were like, oh my God, I dreamt of this. This is what I wanted, and now I have it, and I realize it's not quite enough.
What moment did I realize?
Is there a certain moment there or accomplishment that you if you had had that when you were younger, you would have thought, oh my God, this is it. And now you're realizing this is it, but I want something even bigger.
Yes. Well, being on a number one show, starring on a number one, Saints and Sinners, you know, we're number one because of our dedicated viewers. Yes. And like you said, the little show that could, like literally, because we don't have the marketing dollars that a lot of number one shows receive. Like, we're not on your buses, your billboards, you hear that it's coming out on our social media.
Right.
That's how you know it's coming.
Right.
But our fans just gravitated towards the show and just eat it up and pass the word along. And just, we have a like an intimate bond with our audience because of that. And it's really great to experience. So, but starring on a number one show and then when the season is over, going back home, you know, and it, just sitting there like, what now? Like, that realization was like, oh, okay, so I've always wanted to star on
primetime number one. That's big. That's huge. And especially when you're talking about a series, because that has been some stability.
Oh, love it. Such a blessing. Such a blessing.
Right.
But then when it's over, the filming part is over, and you're sitting there at home.
Yeah.
And then you have the whole rest of the year. That is what really woke me up. Yeah. Like, oh, there's more.
You got to keep going.
You got to keep going.
Yeah, that's so cool, because you're right. A lot of people, that is the goal. Like, once you're on a number one show and it's in prime time, right, and you are you have a starring role, that's the carrot that you've been chasing this whole time.
Yeah, but then I realized that there's so much more work to do. There's more carrots out there to get. That's just one really great one.
Right.
But there are other carrots.
Yeah, and I guess when you look at those careers, I had the honor to interview Jennifer Lewis. Ooh. I was just in awe. And just, you know, I love getting those, having conversations with women of wisdom, you know, because there's so much. But look how many different shows and movies and appearances worked to make up her amazing body of art. Like, that's just amazing. How many shows, how many number one shows, how many blockbuster movies? I mean, it's all, a collective of that.
Yes.
And so you have a great beginning. You definitely have an amazing beginning, because this is a number one show. But like I said, you've been in movies and a lot of different television shows, but we love seeing you hit those accolades and being able to celebrate with you. So we are celebrating Saints and Sinners. You guys premiered last week, the first episode in this final season. First of all, I think the title of the show being Saints and Sinners, I think that the Black community can so relate to this idea of, because when we were younger, most people went to church, or somebody in your family was in church. That was a very big part of the culture, right? But there was a lot of hypocrisy in the church. So there was this dichotomy of this whole saintly behavior, but sinful behavior. Yes. That I think people can relate to. Can you talk a little bit about this, the show, and how, why you think it does have that connection to the audience? Because people will go find, people at first like, okay, where is Bounce? How do I find this show?
Find
I
Bounce?
Need to watch this show. But that means that they do create a more, they get to, they're very intentional about finding the show.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it makes, yes. So it's like, if you watch Saints and Sinners and you find it, that means you really wanted
you
to
really wanted
watch
to, yeah,
the show.
It was important to you and it builds that type of audience. So it's like, I'm going to see my Saints and Sinners.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit when you first came on board, because you play Dr. Christie, but your character has gone through several changes. We are in a weird place right now. I'm not sure. I saw the first two episodes and I'm like, okay, where is this going? Is she going to be able to whip? Is she going to be able to wiggle her way out of this? Talk to us about your character and just the overall show and what you think people really, why people are so intent on finding it to the point where it's become number one.
Well, the writing is phenomenal. It's high caliber storytelling. The writing team, led by Nigel Campbell.
Nice.
The show is created by Ty Scott, who is a woman of color, and had a lot of personal ties to her life.
Okay.
So that, I think people can feel the personal injection in there too. Like these, this really meant a lot to the person who created it.
Right.
All of these characters and the storyline. And then Nigel picked up the mantle and kept running with it with the same type of passion. So I would say the writing, we look so good being so bad. Like, we look fabulous.
Yes.
Okay. We are dressed down,
yes,
honey.
Yes. This, you have Vanessa Bell Calloway. Yes. You got Clifton.
Donna Bisco.
You
Clifton
just
Powell.
Clifton Powell. It's an all-star cast, too. You got some heavy hitters that have been in this business for years, probably almost as long as you've been alive.
Yeah, before I was born,
right.
I think.
That's crazy.
And so to be able to work with legends, and but like our team, like our hair and makeup department, our wardrobe
department. That's another
department,
very important. That's a very important thing as well.
Yes. They very take important. Everybody is black.
So they get it.
They get it. And you know, not that other people can't or don't, because it's so many people, wonderful, talented artists.
Right.
Any color, you know, but just the fact that black beauty is on full display on Saints and Sinners, and people behind the scenes that are creating that black beauty understand that beauty because they grew up with their grandmothers and aunties and moms doing their hair and makeup.
Yep.
And, you know, so
they get it. We don't have to have some of those hills to climb that you may have if people don't understand skin tone, the way to light, the way to apply, all that good stuff. And there, like you said, there's nothing wrong with others doing it, but it's just something about when we're able to do it for ourselves.
Yes.
It just has a different, feels different in the authenticity, I think.
Yes. And they know to make sure our hairlines are together. Like, it's just certain things that don't have to be said, you know?
Right, right.
Our DP is a young, up and coming DP, Jelani.
Nice.
He's from the islands.
Okay.
He's Haitian. Our director is black, Russ Parr. We have Darren Grant,
and
Jerry
a legend.
LaMoth.
Russ Parr is a whole radio legend.
Yes.
Like, I saw that I was like, wow, that is so cool. And I love about this new, like, landscape of black Hollywood, right, is that you have so many opportunities for people to grow and show other things that they can do, you know, because I mean, like I said, Russ Parr, we know his name from radio for years, and now he's, you know, in this new role, but he's killing it.
Yes.
And he has great connections and understands the entertainment, you know, the black entertainment business. Tell us, how did this happen? How did you get connected with the show and what appealed to you about this role initially?
Yes. Well, it was an audition.
Okay.
You know, it was an audition like any other audition, but the difference with this one was it was brought to me via a relationship. Relationships are so important.
Absolutely.
A casting director that had worked with me many times, George Pierre, he remembered me. And, you know, then I had worked with Swirl Films a few times and they remembered me. And when they got their opportunity to shine, they said, let's call Jasmine. And nice. I still had to audition.
Okay.
But I still had to audition. They had to send the tape to the producers and Ty, the creator, and the network, and everybody had to sign off. But just being, having the opportunity to be presented in a serious way was due to
the relationship.
The relationship from them seeing my previous work.
Yep.
And so then everybody signed off. From what I understand, there was somebody else that they had offered the role to.
Okay.
But something happened, and then God said, it's Jasmine.
He slid you on in there.
Slid me right on in there. So that's how it happened. And nice. So I just don't take for granted these relationships you make, because they can make the difference.
They can make the difference. But I think it's important to point out that there are a lot of people that have the opportunity to form relationships, but your relationships are based on what you do when you're in, when you have an opportunity, right? So it's not just meeting the person.
No.
It's the fact that you handled yourself professionally, that you did a great job. That's what makes the relationship. I don't think people understand that, because people will, you know, try to come in and take relationships from other people. And it's like, a relationship is really about the experience that person had with you.
Yes.
So there's not any way to steal someone's relationship. You can't steal that experience. That person is always going to have that experience. That's what they remember from working with you.
Yes.
So it is great, but you really got that job based on the fact that you do a kick-ass job every time you show up, and how you treat people when you're there, regardless of how big or how small they are.
Yes. And it's exactly what you said. It's not just because, and the relationship wasn't through, oh, I'm just like, trying to get to know people.
Right.
My work got me that relationship. That's it. You know, I had to audition to get in that relationship. Mm-hmm. And they said, oh, she's talented. Now, this is before Saints and Sinners. All the work I had done with Swirling and George years prior.
Yes.
We ever knew a Saints and Sinners would come up. Mm-hmm. They had, my work, my talent got me in the door.
There you go.
And then from there, they saw the consistency of my work ethic, like you said, and that solidified them trusting me when they got bigger opportunities
to bring you along, but you still had to show up. We just broke into the mystery of the relationship, the network that people talk about all the time. Because it's like, well, I know this person, but it's not enough to know.
No,
it's not enough to know. It's about how you show up. And then, like you said, I think a lot of times people, shouts out to Swirl Films, they've been really doing an amazing job, and we see so much growth from them, but they've really been kicking butt in Atlanta, because we know there's so much happening here, but it's great when it's actually like people that live here and actually like doing stuff here. But I think that there's so much to be said in younger people that may be watching, because I'm sure there's so many young women or men out there that are listening that may be interested in doing what you do. And they're thinking, oh, I just don't have the relationships. And it's like, no, you're building those every time someone meets you. If they're the janitor, if they're the intern, if they're the assistant, and you're dismissive, you have just destroyed the possibility of building a relationship. And you don't know where that person's going to be tomorrow.
You don't. And let me tell you something else. How I got my first agent was a relationship. It was nobody, you were just talking about the janitor, and everybody is so important and special and valuable to every situation. The wardrobe department helped me get my first agent.
Oh, wow.
At Tyler Perry Studios. His very first studio on Prague Street. It wasn't even finished being built yet. Like when I went
way
in.
That's Tyler Perry way back in the day.
That's history. You know, I'm a part of Atlanta history, everybody. Yeah. But the studio wasn't even finished built. Like, it was still drywall up when I went to audition there. But when I got there, I was in my fitting, and the wardrobe people were like, so we hear you don't have it. People talk. They were like, we hear you don't have an agent. How did you get this job? I'm like, I submitted myself. And they were like, you know what? We're going to tell Mr. Cannon to help you get an agent.
Yeah.
And that's
what happened. Wow. And that's because you were being
nice. And not nice, fake nice. Right, not like trying to butter anybody's biscuit. I'm just a nice person.
Not kissing ass. Because people can tell. Yeah. You could tell that too. Like you could tell. I'm sure you can tell now when people meet you if they're like trying to, if they're angling. It's so obvious. But so obvious. just being authentic and being who you are and treating people with respect pays off. So
just be a kind person, right? With a energy of gratefulness.
That's it.
And that shines through.
That shines through. And then, you know, you couple that with some good old fashioned hard work.
Yes.
As Jennifer Lewis said, get the job done. Get it done. Like, yes, ma'am.
Do the
yes,
work.
Man, do the work.
The work will speak for you.
The work will speak for you every single time. And yeah. It's undeniable. Like that, it doesn't, we don't know how long it's going to take, but we do know that eventually it will pay off. So yes. I want people to stay right there. We're going to come right back. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come right back with the very beautiful, very talented Jasmine Burke, because we know that beauty is not enough either.
No.
Like, it's great, but it's not. It may get you in the door. It may not even get you all the way in Atlanta, because it's just beauty is everywhere.
Beautiful women
it's everywhere. So you got to have the beauty and then all the other stuff. So we're going to come right back with the very beautifully talented Jasmine Burke right here. I'm from Christal XO. Stay tuned. There's more to come.
Keep it locked. Power 108.9, the station for the people.
Yo, it's Michael McFadden of Power 108.9, and I want to ask you a question. Are you looking for a new house? If so, you need to holler at our guy, the mortgage guy, Alvin Jameson. AlvinJameson.com. Yeah, Alvin like the chipmunk, and Jameson like that fine whiskey. Not only can he help you on the purchase of that new home, he can also assist you on that refinance as well. So whether it's FHA, conventional, and of course that VA home loan that you're sitting on right now, yo, call Alvin Jameson. 404-587-9033. Once again, 404-587-9033. Trust the guy we trust here at Power 108.9, Alvin Jameson. AlvinJameson.com, or just call him, 404-587-9033. And of course, tell him you heard it right here on Power 108.9. Let's go.
Hi, Queens. Hi, Queens. Welcome to the Ollie Tony Experience in Atlanta, your source for all things fashion and hair.
Yeah. Baby, I'm just trying to let my hair down.
Please visit us online at shopollietony.com and follow us on Instagram at Ollie Tony Star.
Hey, police are on the hunt for a woman who posed as a witch.
Okay.
She scammed 10 people out of, ask me how much money.
How much?
$100,000.
$10,000 a pop.
For readings and love spells down in Florida. Yeah, Naples police said that they have 10 victims come forward with claims that they were deprived of large amounts of money.
What's her name?
According to a report on Monday. They don't say her name. It just say witch. And it got in their bold letters, too.
They do. Because you copied and pasted it.
No, I wrote that. So if you down in Naples somewhere, you see a lady ride a broom. call your local police.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
Yo, what's going on, y'all? This is Malik McFadden, and did you know that you can listen to Power 108.9 24/7? Just visit the website power108.9.com or simply say Alexa, play Power 108.9. Yeah.
It can see us right now. We are back with Jasmine, actress Jasmine Burke. We're talking about saints and sinners. This final season of Saints and Sinners. Now, I mentioned Clifton Powell and Vanessa Bell Calloway just because those names are huge, but you also have Carly Red.
Carly Red
is holding her own.
She is
holding it down. Michael Anthony, good friend of ours. Mm-hmm. He was here a couple of weeks ago. He's doing amazing. Like, his career is taking off. He's playing a very convincing Ray Ray.
that name.
I know. I was just like, oh, Uncle Ray Ray. Okay. All right. He's eye candy, so we don't mind. Whatever his name is, it doesn't matter. You've got Christian Keys, more mm-hmm. eye candy.
Mm-hmm.
And I appreciate when we have beautiful men and beautiful women. Mm-hmm. It just makes everything better.
Yes.
It makes it go down smoother, right?
Yes. Keith Robinson is the chocolate drop.
Yes.
For
Keith
your
Robinson
flavor.
Is like the grandfather, the older, the distinguished gentleman that you just want to, like, you know, snuggle up and listen to.
Yes.
I love his voice.
He is a distinguished
He's very distinguished,
gentleman.
Right?
He is.
I like his voice. It's like when he listens, you would like pay attention. Like that's the kind of.
Oh, and he sings.
I saw that. So good. I saw that. It's a very soothing baritone. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So shouts out to all the amazing cast, and yes. that's just some of the names. Your character, like I said, is a little out of control. What is happening? You got yourself mixed up in some organ transplant. What's happening? Yes. Doctor? Mm-hmm. What is really going on?
Just cannot get away from that Johnson deviant behavior. Yeah.
It's like I root for you because I want you to, but you just can't quite shake, I guess, what's that already Johnson in there. Yeah.
Thing with the Johnson women are just up to so many things.
Right.
And, you know, it trickles on down to Christy. But I will say, it is Saint Christy this year.
Okay.
She's trying. Okay. She's been trying so hard.
She has tried. To but get I'm from concerned it. About how she's going to. I mean, we're just starting the season, but it just doesn't look good. Things are being uncovered, and it's, and her participation has been discovered that she's a part of this with Ray Ray and
right. And it's so interesting how we don't know each other. Like, we don't know all the people involved, but we're all involved.
Right.
Like, I do my piece, the medical piece, with taking out the organs. I don't know who is going to. Well, I don't know who's going to. And then it's somebody else takes it from there. And then like it's so many different pieces involved. But that like that's the juicy deliciousness of the
story when the story unfolds, right?
It's finding out who all is involved and why and for how long and all that stuff.
And who's being blackmailed. I mean, just all that extortion, all that good stuff. I think the thing about this show is, yes, there's the church aspect, but it's also very, it's in the entertainment industry. It's, you know, it's just, there's all those salacious things. There's a sex, you know, there's affairs and people stepping out, doing that kind of stuff, cheating, whatever. But then you also have, you know, you have church and then you also have a television station. So there's so much going on.
In that little town of Cyprus. Like,
right? I was like, is Cyprus Atlanta?
I know. That's what I say that all the time. I was like, I really think this is Atlanta.
It has to be. Because what other small, very poppin' city would have all this happening? I mean, politicians, it's a lot happening.
Yeah. Cyprus is, I think it's safe to say Cyprus is like Atlanta.
Atlanta. Yeah. Cyprus, AKA Atlanta. Yeah. Okay. You're not tricking us. But the great thing about this is you guys are on Bounce and the show. Also, there's so many different places now you can catch up. I saw Hulu,
the Brown Sugar app.
Yes.
If you miss it in its airing time,
you could go back
and watch to the Brown Sugar app, and then if you just want to binge it later on, you can go to Hulu.
Nice. I love it that there's so many different places, because we all like digest entertainment differently now. I'm gonna like binge a lot of stuff, and then certain things I may want to watch on a weekly basis, but timing gets off, so you know there's certain things I'm like, I'm just gonna dedicate this Saturday to catching up on all of this,
all of that.
What are some of what is your guilty pleasure when it comes to television?
Well, I'm a bit of a geek. I don't mind anybody knowing. I'm proud. I wave my geek.
There's nothing wrong
proud.
With that.
Yeah. I love PBS and GPB. Okay. And
what do you watch?
Finding My Roots.
Okay.
With Dr. Henry Louis Gates.
Yeah.
It's my favorite show.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
I love that show. Okay. And I want to be a guest on there. And because I love Finding Roots, like the discovery.
Have you done that, the 23andMe?
I haven't done the 23andMe, but I did do Ancestry.com and have started the process of finding my family. Okay. And I've been able to trace back to my sixth great grandmother on a plantation in South Carolina.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So I'm going to keep going further and further. But
that's interesting.
Yeah, it's magnificent. Yeah. It makes me feel that I know who I am more.
Yeah, I could see that. I think that we don't have, African Americans as a whole don't really have that connection. And a lot of us, I guess when I look at it, I know my family came from two different, there was some issues because of race, obviously, mm-hmm. when there was mixing of races and stuff like that. But I think it's, when you think of your ancestry, we can say that there's a sense of pride, but we don't really know. There's a mm-hmm. sense of just like not really knowing, and then almost being afraid to learn more if it's not, because we just don't know. Were they slaves? Were they mistreated? Am I going to find something that's going to piss me off?
Oh, you're right. Absolutely. Black experience in America that we know of, mm-hmm. you are going to be upset. Yeah,
find some things that are hurtful.
But it also shows you the resilience too, because... For me, it gave me like another sense of purpose.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, wow, my sixth great great grandmother, I wonder if she could see me now.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And just knowing that
that's good.
I'm a part of bringing my legacy forward.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm standing on
their shoulders. Yeah. That's dope. Speaking of that, a few years, actually, right during COVID, right in the middle of COVID, I reached out to you because I do work with the Georgia NAACP,
mm-hmm.
and we were able to have you do this amazing PSA about, really just getting our community out to vote, to show up. And you all did an amazing job because we definitely did that.
We did that here in Georgia. That was a wonderful campaign. Thank you for calling me.
No, you were awesome. Can you talk a little bit? Because we had you right there in front of Stacey Abrams mm-hmm. and Mayor Keisha Lance Bottoms. But what did that, being a part of that, because you were all for it when I called, I was like, you know, this is what we want to do. We want to have someone to just kind of talk about the success that black women have had mm-hmm. here, and then mm-hmm. to kind of encourage others. And you just jumped in there and did it. Mm-hmm. What did it mean to you to be a part of that on, you know, in such a important election? Like this was like, I want to say life or death for our country at that point.
Mm-hmm.
And so your contribution was huge, you know, to that ninth hour, getting our community out there to mm-hmm. really do that. Mm-hmm. So what did that mean to you?
For me, it meant being a part of history.
Mm-hmm.
And even if in my own little way, if I could be, I felt very honored to be asked to be a part of history in that way.
Mm-hmm.
And if I could use, that's what I have a platform for.
Yeah.
It's not for me. It's for causes. It's to get people's attention.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it's for.
Yeah.
So to be used in that way, it felt like, I'm you living did. Out part of
you,
my purpose.
You did. Yes. It was great. And I love when people do understand that platform gives you so much power.
Mm-hmm.
It gives you so much influence. You know, if you can use that to encourage people in a positive way, that just says more about who you are. Mm-hmm. So we appreciate that. And hopefully people can go back and catch that. If you go, I'm sure it's still up on the website for the Georgia NAACP, but mm-hmm. I have to post that when we post this interview, just to kind of remind people, because we got to do it again. Stacey Abrams is, we got to show up again.
We got to show up for Miss Stacey. That's historical.
Like, yes.
People don't understand how historical of a moment this is about to be.
This is, I feel like we're going to be able to, I feel like she's going to be able to do it. What I love about Stacey Abrams is the fact that she, even in her messaging now, it's like, if you fail at something, you don't give up. You come right back.
Yes.
And she speaks to that. And she's been a beautiful example of that. She did not miss a beat. We see so many politicians that they don't win. They kind of go into obscurity. You don't hear mm-hmm, from anything. Mm-hmm. But she actually got out there in front and continued to push forward, continued to align her influence to push, you know, forward, just the voting and making sure people were aware. And I know that that's going to pay off big when we come back. And actually the preliminaries are in May
mm-hmm,
for
mm-hmm.
the governor, for her race for governor. So we're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back with a moment of hope. We do this every week with Pastor Dwight Buckner. I was listening to Pastor Dwight this morning, actually on my way in. And his message was, what is for you will not pass you. Mm-hmm. He was talking about Boaz and Ruth being out there and how it was so divine. It was just, that was her end. And so many people are looking for something and afraid that someone else may get it if they don't show up the right way. But his message today was, however you are is exactly how God is going to bring you your next blessing. So make sure that you stay tuned. We're coming right back with A Moment of Hope with Pastor Dwight Buckner.
Keep it locked. Power 108.9, the station for the people.
If you're a content creator, social media socialite, influencer, or simply love to record current events, you need the joystick. The joystick is an essential tool for every type of digital content creator. It holds two or more mobile phones or tablets, allowing users to stream and record hands-free on multiple apps simultaneously. And it's lightweight and portable. For more information or to purchase your joystick today, visit our website at www.joystick.com.
My powerful and pristine people, it's your boy E-Money, your favorite engineer. Check it out. If you want to get involved with Power 108.9 as far as partnerships and advertising, if you want to reach our 50,000 plus listeners and viewers per week, please email power1089ads@gmail.com. That's power1089ads@gmail.com. Speak to our marketing director so we can get you set up and ready to go. Let us help you reach your targeted audience and expand your brand.
Question: what's the only station where you can get R&B, hip-hop, pop, and talk radio? Time's up.
Power 108.9, a station for the people.
Welcome to A Moment of Hope with Pastor Dwight. I want you to understand that there are some, what I like to call, divine approvals coming your way. I know you've been denied for things in the past and things did not work out in your favor, but it is true that denial does not mean delay, and delay is not denial. Whatever is meant to come to you is coming to you. And you've just walked into a season, literally, where you're going to walk into some divine approvals. This is the only word that I'm hearing for you today, and that is the word approved. That which did not work out before will work out this season. Sometime you have to try again. You remember when you were a child, when you played kickball, if you missed a ball when you tried to kick it, we would scream, "I need a do-over." This is going to be a season where God is literally going to give you a do-over. And this time you're going to do it and you're going to pass. You've walked into a season of divine approvals. Every single thing you touch this season will be approved. It has your name on it. Nobody else can take it. It is just yours. It is your season of divine approvals. I want you just to write this down today. And I need you to write down, I'm going to be approved for everything that I applied for. See, there are some things you're approved for right now that you don't even know because you're so used to getting no's. Do you understand that you can get 30 no's, but one yes can make up for all of the no's that you have received? This will be your season of divine approvals. I need you to hold this word in your heart today and declare with me all day that this is my month of divine approvals. This has been A Moment of Hope with Pastor Dwight.
Cole Crumple Climax Sessions, and you are listening to Power 108.9.
All right, this is my month for divine approvals. I hope you all received that because I'm definitely receiving it. I'm receiving it. Thank you, Pastor Dwight. This is the time in my life for divine approvals. That what he said about 30 no's, I would always tell when girls, when I would first started hiring young ladies, when I was had my PR company here in Atlanta, I would say, if you haven't gotten a no today, you haven't done enough. Mm-hmm. If you haven't gotten at least two or three no's, you have not been doing a great, you're not doing your job. Mm-hmm. And that sounds, they were like, what are you talking about? I don't want to get a no, I want to get a yes. Like, but you, in order to get to the yes, you have to go through the no's, and you have to look at the no's. You have to run to them almost so that you can get to that yes. How many times have you auditioned for something and didn't get it, but you learned something, or you took something, or you made a connection, or you made a relationship. Someone saw you in your, you know, in that authentic place doing what you do. It might not have been for that, but it ended up being for something else. Yeah, so absolutely. I'm going to receive that.
I receive it too.
I hope, hey, if you don't receive it, then, you know, that's on you, because it's out there. When the word comes, you say it. I think, you know, you take the meat, you throw back the bones, whatever's for you, receive it. So Definitely this is a time for divine approval. Speaking of divine approvals, we have a season here that is, I'm sure, going to be, it's going to make more history. Yes. With you all. tell people where they can tune in and what they can expect. We've given you a little bit of a tease with this Oregon situation they got going on. But it's funny because these headlines, as crazy as that sounds, they actually are things that are happening in Georgia and across the country, mm-hmm. from the people, human trafficking for organ donors. Yeah. I mean, for organ, transplants and illegal mm-hmm. transplants, to, of course, the usual trickery and foolishness that happens anytime there's a big city and there's money to be made, there's going to be some foolishness happening, right? Yes. With crime. But all of these things, it's very salacious, but they are also ripped from the headlines, which mm-hmm. is kind of like, it's entertaining, but it's a little bit like, oh crap, like that's real.
It's real. This may be a soap opera, but
it's pulling from real. It's giving real. Mm-hmm. It's giving reality, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. What can people expect coming up from this final season from your character? Mm-hmm. From what you can share with us, give us a little sneak peek, Jasmine. A little snippet. A little scoop.
Just a little scoop.
Yeah, a little scoop.
A little dollop. Well, you know, Dr. Christie is excited to be a doctor again. We all know that she was fighting to get her medical license back, and she has it. By golly, she has it.
Okay.
And she's really excited to have it back. That's her mission and passion in life, something mm-hmm. that her family didn't give her. That's something she found on her own, wanting to help people, and now mm-hmm. she's back to officially doing that.
Okay.
But her grandmother, Lady Bird, has, you know, pulled her back into the sinning part of it all.
Yeah.
And
I'm so concerned about her license at this point. I'm very concerned.
I'm concerned too. But she's trying to walk that thin line between having it back now and still using it
in the wrong ways.
And so we're gonna see what happens. Like, can she balance it, or mm-hmm. is she gonna tip back over, or is she going to finally rid herself of the Johnson curse,
that generational curse? Yes. You know what, it's interesting, because how do you see this, because I feel like when you all play characters, right, mm-hmm. there's good and bad in everybody.
Yes.
But each character has a different balance of good to bad, right? Mm-hmm. So some people may have a little bit, and then others have a lot of good, and then some have a lot of bad but a little good. But it's like, depending on who you are to that person in their life will probably determine
what side of them you get.
Right. Right. Mm-hmm. So how do you tap into characters that are doing bad things, but you still want to show that good side of them? And she's a good example of that. Mm-hmm. Like, you want to root for her, but it's like, but that's also very real.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, it's real life. You know, we all have two sides, or four or five.
Right.
Sides. But so it's just like, for me, playing a dynamic character, a complex mm-hmm. character, is connecting to the good in them.
Okay.
No matter what the bad things that she's doing, mm-hmm. connecting to her good helps define for me and paint her reason why for doing bad things.
You know,
the things that, because, okay, if we take it, you know, a little deeper mm-hmm. into psychology,
okay,
we're all motivated by the mistakes we make are motivated by a lack in us, or a need somewhere that's not being met.
That was Jasmine just dropped some gems there. That's huge, though. That's true. And I think that's when you think about why people do what they do. It always, for me, my personality is like that. I'm a balanced person. So if someone does something to me that's hateful, or I'm always trying to figure out, but why would they do that? And I know it has nothing to do with me. Mm-mm. You have to figure out, okay, what is motivating them to do that? And then depending on what I feel that is, it can help me either give them grace.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and empathy, or realize that I need to let them go.
Yes.
You know, so it just kind of depends on what their motivation is for doing what they do.
Mm-hmm. It's like, whatever people are doing has nothing to do with this.
Right.
Because we are human beings, we have a tendency, or we've been groomed to mm-hmm. say, well, what am I doing? But the reality is, you're not doing anything wrong. It's whatever's going on in that person's life.
Right.
You're just a a target or a punching bag or
casualty of war.
You're a casualty of war. Mm-hmm. So it's like our job is to say, okay, that has nothing to do with me.
Right.
Let me go into myself and figure out, put my armor on so that as things are coming at me,
they're not penetrating.
They don't penetrate.
There you go. What has been your favorite role to play thus far?
Oh, thus far. It's been so many good ones. I've been really blessed. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't get pigeonholed into one type of stereotype. I play all kind of young ladies and women and girls. But I would say my favorite had to... I love playing Dr. Christie. Mm-hmm. And... Oh my God, it's so many. That's hard to answer.
Give us one more. What was the most different from your personality? Because I've heard people say that they enjoy getting a chance to do something that's so opposite of themselves, because it, you know, gives you some flexibility and you can actually have fun. Has there been a role that was completely not Jasmine? Like you couldn't even relate to this person, but you had a chance to get to know her.
I played this crazy girl, and when I say crazy, I mean like for real. Like she literally snapped out. It was a Russ Parr movie, actually.
I remember that movie.
Yeah, that was the furthest away from who I am, but it was.
She had mental issues.
She literally had a mental issue, and she was hiding it.
Yes,
but then she couldn't keep it in too much longer, and she snapped in front of the whole family, like snap, crackle, pop,
a few times. Yeah,
and it was like, whoa.
Yeah,
don't marry her, son.
Yeah, I was like, the relationship. He was like, I can't. I'm not gonna be able to.
It was with Jackie Long. Me and Jackie Long were playing love interest. He's so fun to work with.
That's cool. I remember that movie though, because we've really been talking a lot more about mental illness in the Black community, especially over the last, I would say, 10 years, especially the last five, really. But that was one of the first movies I saw where really it kind of showed what a person's life could be like, because a lot of people are able to hide their issues until a certain point.
It's very real.
And she was unable to hide it any longer.
It's very real. And when I say crazy, I mean that and with all the love, because we all have some crazy in us.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
We have levels. Everyone has levels of it. But that was far, but it was fun.
Yeah, because you got to be something different. Yeah, you got to snap.
don't you want to snap sometimes?
That sounds like, fun, yeah.
You just, this one good time, you just want to let it all out on somebody.
Sometimes people need to see the snap to know that it's there. They may not need to see it ever again. They just may need to be introduced to the fact that I look,
it can go there.
It's some different sides, Like I had a moment in my life where I realized sometimes you don't know who you are until you go through something. It's like, oh, I did not know that was in there.
Yeah.
But it came out.
But I bet it was refreshing. Like afterwards, you know, you probably felt so light. Like,
I felt like a different person. I can just briefly say, when I went through probably the most heartbreaking experience of my life, and I didn't really curse. Like I was real proper growing up. This experience introduced me to the word MF, which is a horrible word. I had never said it, but
you said MF.
I said it with such happiness and freedom, because I was just that was the only word that could explain what I was feeling at the moment. And so I realized there was this whole nother person in there. I've never had a fight in my life. This whole nother person had been waiting for an opportunity to fight. Like she's been
to
there
fight
the whole
for
time.
You
she wanted
yeah,
to
she wanted that I think she yeah. that was just the part of you that wanted to fight for you.
Yeah, and she had been dormant for 31 years. And she came out at 32. Praise God. But yes, so let people know where they can find. We know that we can find Saints and Sinners in so many different places, but where can they watch it if they want to catch it hot and fresh?
Hot and fresh. That's the only way to receive these buns right out the oven. Right. Every Sunday night on Bounce TV, 8 p.m. Eastern time, 9 p.m. Central time.
It would have to be Sunday. So on Easter Sunday, make sure that you get your food in, enjoy your family, and then tune in. Tune in, because I'm telling you, this final season, you all have poured everything into it.
Yes.
and it's going to be really good. I'm so happy to have you here. Thank you so much for stopping by and congratulations. Always. We're so proud of you.
Thank you.
Continue to be so proud of you and can't wait to see what's next. So whatever happens next, whatever approval Pastor Dwight prophesied over you today, you're going to come back and share it with us, you know, as you have news, right?
Absolutely. Oh, you know I will.
All right, we're going to hold Jasmine to that. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As you know, we'll be here right back here next Tuesday with more information, another moment of hope from Pastor Dwight Buckner. So I'm so thankful that he's a part of this, but I'm so thankful that you all have a chance to hang out and watch every week right here from Christal XO. It's my way of having lunch with you and giving you something good to think about for the rest of the week. Have a beautiful week, and I will see you all next Tuesday. From Christal with love, come on. From Christal with love, come on. Let's talk about it.